أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وآله الطاهرين Dear sisters and brothers in Iman, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Coronavirus, known as COVID-19, is indeed a historic test and trial of our own time. In Islamic terminologies, I can describe it as al-bala, al-ibtila, or al-fitna. We have to realize that life cannot be without tests and trials. Once Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa salam saw a person praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he says, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-fitna. O Allah, I seek protection with you against the trials. Amir al-Mu'mineen told him that this is not the right way of praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there is none but that he or she is tested in one way or another. Rather, you should seek Allah's protection against mawallatul fitan, the misguidance of the tests. Coronavirus is also a fitna for us. It has forced most of us to stay at home. Many countries have declared a state of emergency with all essential businesses closed. This bala can also be a trigger for misguidance and deviation. Staying at home for 2 weeks or more with your spouse and or with your children would create its own set of challenges. As husband and wife, you must dip into the reservoir of your patience and understanding in the sense of mawadda and rahma that Allah has given to your hearts and express that towards one another more than ever before. Sometimes when a couple are together uninterruptedly, they might irritate each other. You must do your part to avoid or minimize this possibility. You know, number one, be creative in finding ways to give some room to one another. Maybe a quiet time for reading or to go for a stroll in the neighborhood if your local restrictions allow that. Number two, balance out the alone time with quality time spent together. Communicate and do activities which overlap both of your interests. Number three, help one another with household chores. Remember the example of Imam Ali and Bibi Fatima, salawatullah alayhima. They used to help one another and not just go by the legal, you know, limits and boundary of their responsibilities. Number four, most importantly, this is the time to be patient with one another. In this extraordinary situation, don't hope that everything will be to the level of your expectation. Extraordinary circumstances are another form of test for your relationship. If you manage expectations, if you exercise empathy and provide support, your relationship will come out stronger on the other side. A further set of challenges come with children at home during a prolonged lockdown. For many communities, there is no more daycares, no schools, no extracurricular activities. Staying indoors all day alone or with siblings will not be easy for the children. The parents must be more patient in dealing with the children in these extraordinary circumstances. Number one, spend some time furthering their academic studies. Perhaps supplement this with teaching them real world skills as well as keeping it interesting. Number two, have a fixed reading time with them every day to explore Islamic storybooks. Number three, browse through reliable websites for online material and documentaries suitable for your children. But remember to engage and supervise them. Don't see this as a virtual babysitting opportunity. Number four, challenge them to memorize some short surahs, one surah per week, and give them a prize when they complete each one. If they are older, explore the translation of those surahs with them. Number five, for younger children who are not yet baligh, set a time for them to pray and practice salat under your supervision. This could also be a refresher for yourself. Number six, keep your children in touch with their grandparents and other elders of the family through video calls so that they can build stronger bonds with one another. Number seven, the last point here for the children, remember that they are children. Structure and discipline are important, but some free and flexible time for them to play, explore, or simply sleep in sometimes are okay. Finally, always remember to pray, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min madallatil fitan. O Allah, I seek your protection against the misguiding aspects of tests and trials. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep everyone under his protection of mercy and safety. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.